Watford, Dorsey, Anthony Lynn. Crazy offseason. Let's begin.
This is LeGarrette Blount here, man, three-time Super Bowl champion. I just want to give you a shout-out to the YouTube channel, Micro Mike, man.
Eddie Murray, former Detroit Lion. Make sure you watch Micro Mike on YouTube.
Calvin Johnson Jr. here, a.k.a. Megatron. Big shout-out to Micro Mike and YouTube channel, man.
Keep on talking everything Detroit Lions, and I just got to remind you, man, happy wife, happy life.
What is going on, YouTube, and welcome to Detroit Lions Talk with Mike and Mike. We talk all things Detroit Lions news, rumors, analysis, breakdown, and everything regarding our franchise. And in this video, we're going to be talking about, obviously, the latest rumors of Matthew Stafford, but there was some acquisitions that took place, one being John Dorsey and an underrated one in offensive coordinator Anthony Lynn. And we're going to get to talk about that in this video. Obviously, what happened the other day with Matthew Stafford parting ways with the Detroit Lions agreement into terms. That was a massive story, but other things that did take place need to be talked about. And let's just go ahead and jump right into it. Let's talk about Anthony Lynn, the new Detroit Lions offensive coordinator. What a great hire for the Detroit Lions, in my opinion. The reason this is such a great hire is we right now have a young coaching staff, and we're talking about the head coach, the defensive coordinator. They are new. We got a general manager who's new as well. Anthony Lynn is not. He was a head coach with the Los Angeles Chargers 4 years. Before that, offensive coordinator, and he developed Justin Herbert into a very quality quarterback as a young quarterback coming to the league. Anthony Lynn's offense was very good, I believe, in my opinion, for the Chargers. I didn't think he should have been fired, but when he was fired, I said the Detroit Lions should take a look at Anthony Lynn, and I thought it would be a possible target for head coach. Now he's our offensive coordinator. Fantastic news. I feel like this is a great person to help develop the young quarterback that we're going to be drafting in this year's draft. Anthony Lynn has a good offense for young people, and he's good at developing the young quarterback, and that is very vital for this franchise. Folks, make sure you hit that like button. Let's get to 250 likes in this video. The more likes we get, the more the video gets out, and the legacy media can hear what we, the fan base, has to say, not what they have to say, but what the fans of Detroit has to say. Let them know that we are not silent and we're not going to keep our voices unheard. And most importantly, he has the experience for head coaching position and can help out Dan Campbell with things he may not understand being a young head coach. And that is very important for this franchise going forward, to have some sort of veteran presence, a veteran voice for the Detroit Lions team, and he will do that. I think it's a slam dunk hire for offensive coordinator. Obviously, Daryl Bevel going to Jacksonville, he's not going to be here. And with the Detroit Lions doing a complete and utter rebuild, this is a good choice for offensive coordinator. And I am really happy that he is the guy that they picked. Obviously, when we go to the defensive coordinator, we got Glenn. He is new as well. So again, having a veteran presence on that coaching staff will help out. We have a young general manager, another than Brad Holmes. So what did he do? He went and he got John Dorsey, formerly of the Cleveland Browns and the Kansas City Chiefs, for a help and a veteran view of the general manager position. We're really beefing up this team to have a young core of leaders as well as veterans to help them out. And I think he will be a good hire to assist the general manager, Brad Holmes. He doesn't need to be the general manager. He doesn't need to be the main voice, but there's things he can help out with. Brad Holmes is good with scouting college, but he may need help out with free agents. He may need help out with the operations that take place behind the scenes for a GM. And so it's good to have a guy that's done it before, but he's not calling the shots. And I think that's perfectly fine. Now, I would not want Dorsey as the official general manager, but since he's just an assistant, I think that's perfectly fine to have a veteran voice to help out the young general manager. Because guess what, folks? Right now, Matthew Stafford, the discussion for the Detroit Lions trading him is taking place right now. And it's important to have these veteran individuals to make sure that we don't get shafted a little bit, because guess what? We're going to be looking for a young rookie quarterback in this year's draft. No doubt about it at this point. I've been saying this for every mock draft that I've done. The Detroit Lions, whether it be Zach Wilson or Trey Lance, could be a Justin Fields. They're going to be getting a young quarterback because we are starting from scratch, basically. And so it's important to have these guys in here. And Anthony Lynn can teach them, and Dorsey can help out Brad Holmes in that matter. What do you think we can get for Matthew Stafford? I'm thinking for sure a first-round draft pick and maybe a third-round pick, a first and a third. But there's a ton of rumors flying around right now that the Colts are interested with multiple first-round draft picks. You have the Denver Broncos are interested. The rumor is the ninth overall pick in the next year's first. But right now, it's nothing but rumors. I think that's a little bit high. It'd be difficult for me to assume that we could get two first-round draft picks. But I feel we can get a first and a third for sure. And that's kind of where we're going to go from there. What can they do with that pick? Well, again, Brad Holmes is a very much a go ahead and go to the pinned comment and tell me, do you like the hire of John Dorsey as assisting the general manager, Brad Holmes? It's simple. All I got to do is press Y for yes and for no. I'm curious to see what the fan base thinks. Bold guy regarding the draft, regarding making moves. So who knows what's going to happen? Trading Stafford. Maybe we stay at 7. Maybe we go up in the draft to secure the quarterback. Maybe we get multiple. Like the sky is the limit regarding what is going to take place. But what we've seen from Sheila Ford, how she stated she hated losing, and she made this plan and a promise to the fans out there that they're going to do this differently. They have done it differently. No doubt about it. In my lifetime, I haven't seen such a moves that's being made in the offseason. It's quite a bit. Quite a bit. I mean, you're talking about firing Quinn Trisha, turning around at that point, do an extensive interview process for the general manager, get a young up-and-comer there, Dan Campbell, out-of-the-box head coach. He turns around and gets a young defensive coordinator from the New Orleans Saints, hires a veteran former head coach, offensive coordinator, gets Dorsey to help out in trading Matthew Stafford here in the next couple of weeks. We probably should have an idea of what it's going to be, and then can we really focus on the future of the team. It's amazing to see everything that's taking place this offseason. I predicted it was definitely not going to be boring, and boring is the last thing that is taking place right now for the Detroit Lions. And it's exciting. It is exciting whether you want Stafford gone or not, whether you want, you know, having a young guy as coach or not, or a young general manager. Either way, it is exciting, and it's a fresh start of a new era of Detroit. And I'm excited to see what's going to take place via free agency and trading Stafford, the NFL draft, how many draft picks we're ultimately going to have, who is going to be the quarterback going forward. But if you look at everything that has been taking place, it does point to a dual threat quarterback. It points to a different mindset on defense, a more physical football team, probably going to run the football a lot more than we're used to here in Detroit. This is what this team needed. This is what is required for this franchise to going forward, making legitimate moves. We've made a lot of moves so far this offseason, and it's great. And I expect a lot more moves to be made going forward, and it's just crazy. It's like it's something that I haven't witnessed and felt like. I mean, when we fired Matt Millen, we just basically brought in Mayhew. He was with Matt Millen, so it's been a push down scenario. Then from there, we get Quinn. What does he do? He keeps Caldwell, fires him, brings us his own guys. This is going to be completely different. This has shattered the norm here in Detroit, and hopefully this is the correct direction that this team is going forward. But I support the direction because I am a Lions fan. And you know when something is being done right is when the legacy media doesn't like what we're doing. They can't stand the hire of Dan Campbell, and I love it. I love it. I love their reaction of being so angry, because the reason why they're so angry is they hate our city. They hate our team. And guess what? I don't care. They can hate us all they want in Detroit. We're a different type of breed here. We need individuals that want to be here and are willing to fight tooth and nail to be in the city of Detroit, because we're filled with blue collars. We're tired of losing. We want a winner. We're very multicultural, and we're all one pride. And so, media, hey, take a back seat. This is a new time for Detroit. It's not the same type of stuff that's taking place. I'm not going to say this can result to wins or losses or whatever, but all I can say is, media, sit back and enjoy the ride, because we're coming. The pride is rising, and we're not going to sit here and take your nonsense anymore, dogging our football team. This is one pride where we all ride together, whether it be good or bad. This is a different change and a different view for the Detroit Lions, and you're just going to have to deal with it. In the upcoming videos, we're going to be talking a lot here about, obviously, trade scenarios, destinations for Matthew Stafford, who's going to be the next quarterback, in the One Pride podcast on Thursday at 6:30 p.m. Eastern time. Make sure you hit that notification bell. Only around 10% of everybody is notified who subscribe to my channel. The notifications you get results in you not missing out on content.